Hey folks, Michael Collins again from EnviroReporter.com on January 22nd, 2012. As you can see, we've got our HEPA filters out, and this is a bi-monthly cleaning of these filters, and we always take the opportunity to check them. One thing I'm going to talk about real quick before we do actually check them is this idea of radon progeny affecting our readings. Radon progeny is the result of gaseous emissions from the Earth that are so-called natural, and they can be washed out of the sky with rains and produce a higher level of radiation on one's nuclear radiation monitor than would be coming from artificial sources higher than background. What we've discovered, we discovered this in Michigan over the holidays, where we tested two different rain fronts where the rain came in, we tested it, measured it against background, and it was right at background, meaning it didn't show any indications of radon progeny. Now, also here in Santa Monica, in just the last couple of days, we had a rainstorm come through. It was on the southern jet stream, and lucky for us, it didn't show above background. Indeed, it showed under background, the rain precipitation sample we took. What the point of this is that radon progeny is not in all detections, number one. Number two, in the ones that we've been detecting, it certainly hasn't been, meaning that anything over background that we are detecting, that is over 15% above the margin of error of our machine, which is 15% plus or minus, anything in excess of that we can take as a legitimate reading. Now, another thing, people say, no, wait a minute, you're testing these filters here and they've been running a couple months and you're creating a ratio against the background rain, a background ambient air radioactivity. Well, the fact of the matter is this. This dust that we've been collecting, these HEPA filters, there shouldn't be any activity in it at all. And we have kept these samples. I've gone back and looked at them, and they have maintained a high radioactivity. So what we're looking at here is, and we're just about to check to see what we've got now, we're looking at radioactivity that cannot be explained by radon progeny, and that is also higher than background. Now, background, as you know, is what occurs naturally from the cosmos, from the sun, from radioactive soil, uranium, thorium, potassium, radium, and what we do is try to figure out how much over background are these things that we test. So we're going to now test these two filters, knowing full well that they our background in here right now in Radiation Station Santa Monica is 41.6 counts per minute. So we want to see if we get anything over background that's legitimate. So let's check it out. The ticking you hear are ionizing events going through the Inspector Nuclear Radiation Monitor, one of the best in the business. Now we're at double background. I'm just checking one part of this filter. I'll turn the filter around on this Honeywell model to see what we get. Now we're at 98, now we're at 106, it's going up. Now we're at 116, closing in on three times background. As you know from previous posts on EnviroReporter.com, three times background is considered by the California Highway Patrol to be a hazmat incident. Well, if that's the case, we're at over three times right now. And this is air being filtered in our Santa Monica home. Got a high of 122. Now we're going to just tip this filter and go around. See what we get. This is the worst nightmare of all those meltdown fallout deniers, which is proof that we have radiation in the air that we're testing that is coming in significantly above background. Well, that's not good. We're up at 132. Radiation comes in bursts. It's not homogeneous. So I'm very careful with the inspector here. I don't want to touch it. Get its detecting screen gooed up at all by this stuff. 130 again. We had a high of 132. Finding hot spots as we roll around here, you can hear it. You can see it with the red light going on and off. I'm very close to this particulate matter. Obviously, one of the lessons of this video you're watching is it's a good thing to have a HEPA filter, even if I don't know how to say it right. I've never known whether it's HEPA or HEPA. Another hotter than the rest of it area, went up to 126. So for all you meltdown fallout deniers out there, remember this. If we're not getting radon progeny in the rain here at Radiation Central, Radiation Station Central here in Santa Monica, 134, then why would we expect it in just the air itself? 144. This shouldn't be in your air, folks. Now, another thing we do is obviously I've got to vacuum off these filters to make them more efficient, because I can't clean the air very well when they're all gummed up like this. So I'll be doing that after I do this. Now I'm going to check this other filter. See what we got over here. This is a Kenmore plasma wave. I'm a little farther away from the screen because I got that black framing around it, meaning I'm not getting close to the alphas like the other one, not as close. Last time this was hotter, than the one on the left. Now when you hear me roll over something and it starts picking up, we're talking hot spot. So this one isn't reading as hot. This, however, is. Now you gotta wonder how this get here. The last rains we took, we checked, they came in at under background. So there's another mechanism happening. We think we have discovered what that mechanism is. We're going to be discussing this further, both on radio and on EnviroReporter.com. You want to hear what we do on the radio? You just go to our radio section. It's all there. Now you know, folks, like I said at the top, this is not supposed to be in our air. Alpha radiation, it's between 60 and 1,000 times more dangerous than beta or gamma. So we got a high of 146. We're going to vacuum off these filters. Stay tuned for further radiation testing results. Listen to us on the radio, EnviroReporter.com. Thank you.